You are watching the Living Faith Network, where faith is alive.
I was a very active and free-spirited person. I love to party. I would draw a big crowd. It was not a problem. Cars would be double parked, triple parked. I was a very popular person, so I knew a lot of people. So if the word was out that I was gonna have a party, the party was gonna be packed, and it was on for the people. And so everybody would be there, and it would be a party that wouldn't stop. Drinking, you know, they had smoking, you name it. It was everything at the parties. Once it's over and the party stops and all the friends go away, it's a depression that sets in for the absence of those people. The party was just the front. Inside, I was empty. I wasn't still fulfilled. It was still a loneliness on the inside of something that needed to have been fulfilled that really wasn't there. The reality set in when I started losing my friends. My friend was killed. She was killed by her boyfriend, and he invited both of us together. And to this day, it was only by the grace of God that I didn't go, because I would have been with her. And I just feel like he probably would have murdered both of us. I had been in a car accident, and I had been in 5 car accidents. And my girlfriend's sister was a member of the Universal Church, and she said she found it was strange with me being in so many car accidents back to back. And she felt that I needed to come to the Universal Church and to get some prayer. I did come to the Universal Church. God began to really move in my life, and he gave me peace, knowing that he would supply my need. I wouldn't have to depend on man to supply my needs. So I really was brought up in a holiness church, and I knew about the Holy Spirit, but I wasn't activating it. I wasn't exercising my faith. I wasn't exercising the correct walk to be able to walk in the full fulfillment of the Holy Spirit. When I made the commitment not to straddle the fence and to walk in the light, after receiving the Holy Spirit, it was a transition. It was a transformation in my life. I didn't want to do those things anymore. I became a new creature. The things that I used to do, I didn't want to do them anymore. I didn't feel comfortable with doing it. The people that I used to be with, I didn't feel comfortable with being with them and doing those things anymore. And God transformed my life. He took away the old and created the new. I don't feel that emptiness no more. I'm so busy. I'm so busy with the things of God. I don't have time to even think about what I did in the past, because I'm fulfilling those needs with doing the things through the work of Christ. I'm encouraging and challenging anybody out there that feels so empty that you feel like you have to party to be fulfilled, is to meet us here at the Universal Church. Go there and you will reach the gratification. That emptiness that you're feeling, you'll be fulfilled if you come to that ministry. No more depression. I don't have time to be depressed. I'm too busy to be depressed. It's too much things to be done in the church. It's too many souls to be said, you know, too many people that I could tell my story to. It's too many people that I could reach. I don't have time to be depressed and sad and worried about what I don't have. I go out to save souls. I go out to evangelize and to witness. That's my fulfillment, of telling people the goodness of Jesus. That fills my gratification of the emptiness and the loneliness that I had with the parties.
And now with you, the Encounter with God, live stream service with Bishop Joshua.
Thank you. Amen. Good morning. God bless you in Jesus' name. Please close your eyes. Let us start our service in the presence of God. I believe in you. I believe in you. You are the God of miracles. I believe in you. I believe in you. You are the God of miracles. The one who made the blind to see. Move here in front of me. Move here in front of me. The one who made the deaf to hear is silencing my every fear. Silencing my every fear. Somebody to say to him, I believe in you. I believe in you. You are the God of miracles. The one who made the blind to see. Move here in front of me. Move here in front of me. The one who made the deaf to hear is silencing my every fear. Silencing my every fear. To say, I believe.
I believe in you.
You are the God of miracles.
You are the God of miracles.
If you believe in Jesus, you shall say, I believe. I believe in you. Oh, I believe in you. You are the God of miracles. Holy Spirit, we believe in you. We believe in your word, your unfailing word, your unfailing power. My Lord Jesus, I believe that today this person shall see a miracle in his life. Today this person shall see a miracle in her life. No disease, no infirmity, nothing, no one can overpower you. You are the great God. And when you act, nobody, oh yes, I say, nobody can reverse your power. Nobody can stop your power. So Holy Spirit, I am praying to you. I am asking you, show your power today. Show your power, my Lord, in this service. In a way that everybody in this service will see how great you are. Together we say, Jesus, we gather together in your house, in your presence. I want to see thy power in my life. So now close your eyes and pray your prayers. He said, my house will be called a house of prayer. So right now in this house of prayer, talk to the Lord. Call upon the name of the Lord. Holy Spirit, come quickly to hear us. Come quickly to hear our voice, our prayers. Answer these people. One thing for sure, my Lord. Nobody will leave this place the way they came. Nobody will leave this place empty-handed. This person shall have an experience with your power. This person shall have an experience with your spirit, your power and your spirit. This is what I pray, my Lord and Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. I believe in you. The God of miracles.
You are the God of miracles.
Amen. Look, please. The scripture says, do not despise prophecy. Hey. Do not despise prophecy. What is prophecy all about? Prophecy is not to guess future. A prophecy is not to guess people's life. I'm going to show today to you what the prophecy is all about. By the way, Satan uses people nowadays. You better be careful when somebody comes to your house or even inside of the church and they say, I am a prophet and I see this, I see that. Hey, run away from this person. Yes, run away, because that person is full of demons. Full of demons. When somebody comes to you and they say, I saw what happened yesterday, or I see your future, run away. This is the demon talking to you. And usually they have this tone of voice that sounds spiritual. Oh, my servant, I am a prophet of the Lord. You know this voice, this speech to deceive you. And you believe when they say, I see this, I see this, I see that, run away. Me, I am a prophet of the Lord. Hey, myself, I am a prophet of the Lord, but I don't see anything. I don't see anything. I don't see your future. I did not see you yesterday. I don't have this power. But I am a prophet. How? How am I a prophet? When I prophesy your blessing. When I prophesy your turnaround. This is the right prophecy. Prophecy is a declaration. Prophecy is a declaration of something. Like this lady, I have her testimony here. I did not see her because she was in her house. I was holding the TV program. But I prophesied her healing. And here she is. Coming to me here, please. Can I have a mic for her? Do you have a mic in the church? No mic. Pastor Marcos, a mic? Thank you. Muy amable.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Bishop.
How are you?
Fine, thank you, Bishop.
One day she was watching the TV. What time was that?
It was 5 a.m. in the during the mornings before
I'm
go
sorry,
to.
What's your name again?
Sylvia Edwards.
Miss Sylvia Edwards, she came into the program last week. I brought her here to show to you what the prophecy is all about. She was watching the TV. I did not see her. She saw us on the TV. And there was a prophecy of healing.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
What was your problem?
My problem is that before when I went to the doctor, they said that I am on borderline of diabetes.
Borderline of diabetes.
Yes, and my thyroid was overactive.
Overactive.
Yes, and I have high cholesterol.
For how many years of your life you took medication?
25 years for my overactive thyroid.
25 years. They prescribe medication to take?
Yes.
Every morning.
Every morning on an empty stomach. And during that time I'm taking it, I'm looking at you.
To 85 years.
Yes.
85 years take medication.
Yes.
One morning she was there to take the medication and she saw the church on the TV. You saw us.
Yes.
What was the prophecy for you?
The prophecy is that I have to have faith as what you preached on the TV.
Mm-hmm. And what did you do?
And I started to develop my faith and start to pray more and start reading the Bible more.
Did you pray with me on the TV?
On the TV, yes. Mm-hmm. And you said, come, get up. Put your hands on my hand. It's like, oh my God, he's talking to me. So I got up and I put my hand on your hand.
And like this?
Yes. Yes. Mm. And you prayed. And you prayed and you prayed and you prayed. Then when I went to the doctor on November 1st, the doctor says, okay, I'm going to take some blood and check on your on you. 2 days after, she called me back and she said, she haven't seen any thyroid. My cholesterol was good. My diabetes, I'm no longer.
Sugar level.
The sugar level was good. It was way down. Yes, and I was healed.
She was healed. The Lord Jesus Christ healed her. Come on now. Jesus is the healer. The prophecy took place in her life.
Yes.
Amen. Listen. My hand, place your hand upon mine.
Yes.
My hand did not heal her. My hand is just like hers. Bones and flesh.
Yes.
It's not the hand of a ghost. It's the hand of yours, like yours.
Yes.
Bones and flesh. I don't have a miracle hand. But she believed in the prophecy. This
yes.
is the prophecy, the word of God. If you see a prophet say, I saw this, I see that, run away, because this is not true. I did not see her, but she was taking her medication. She used her faith.
Yes,
it was
my
faith.
Huh? It was my faith.
Her faith, she's healed. The doctor said, thyroid is good, sugar level is good, cholesterol is good, she's healed.
Amen.
Great is your faith. God
Thank
bless
you, God,
me, Sylvia.
God, thank you, Pastor.
Amen.
Thank you, Bishop.
Get your bottle of water right now. Get your bottle of water. And I want you to get the Bible as well. Where is your Bible? Get the Bible. Let us do something different. I believe in you. I believe in you. You are the God of miracles.
You are the God of miracles.
Place your water upon the Bible now.
I believe in you.
Your water upon the Bible. Come on.
I believe in you. You are the God of miracles.
Listen, the bottle of water is upon the Bible. By faith, look, by faith, these promises, these prophecies will come inside of your water. And when you drink of it, you are going to drink the word. Amen? The word will enter your body. High cholesterol, thyroid disease, inflammation. Any disease that you have, the Lord Jesus is the healer. Raise it now. If you don't have a Bible, raise the word, the water. Next week you bring the Bible. Every Sunday, please. Close your eyes. Based on your word, I prophesy healing. Mrs. Sylvia was at home and a miracle happened there. My Lord, we are in church and miracles happen right now. So Holy Spirit, I present to you now this water. Let this person drink of this water and let the promises, I am the Lord who heals you, Let this promise enter their bodies, and let this person be healthy, be healed all diseases, to disappear all diseases, cancer, tumor, disappear right now. Open your eyes. You who have an incurable disease, come here before the altar. Even if you are not feeling pain, but you have a health condition, health issue, come here before the altar. You have this heart problem. You have this blood disease, blood infection. Come here before the altar. This morning, before you came, you had to take your medications. I don't condemn you, but I say, come here to be healed. You have this health infirmity, this disease, come to the altar. Yes. If you have your Bible, hold it now. Listen to me, please, people. Listen to me. A man went to see a doctor. He had a problem in his leg. He could not walk, just limp. And he went to see his doctor. Listen. And the doctors checked his leg and told him, sir, learn how to live like this. This is because of your age. The man was in his 80s. It's because of your age. You are in your 80s and you have to learn how to live with it. And he asked the doctor a question. He said, doctor, the other leg is also 80, but I don't have no problem. The other leg is as old as this one. In other words, he said, I don't accept it. If somebody in your family has the same problem, do not accept it. You are with Jesus. Amen? And when they say, old people have diseases. No, you are. The body might be old, but the spirit is young. The spirit is new. The faith is new. Amen? Amen, friend? Oh, they said your mother had, your father had, your grandfather had. You should have as well. No, 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 no. Believe in prophecy. You are here before the altar. When you drink of this water that is on your Bible, you are going to drink of the prophecy. Believe in prophecies. And you shall be healed. Amen? Hold it now. Close your eyes. And you who are at home, get a cup of water, a bottle of water over there as well. Everybody to close their eyes. In the name of Jesus, I come against this disease, this incurable disease, this cancer, tumor. I say to you, tumor, bust now. Blast right now. I say to you now, infirmity, disappear from this body. Tumor, get out of this body. I say to you now, the tumor in the stomach, the cancer, yes, this high blood pressure, sugar level, go back to the normal now. High cholesterol, back to normal. Yes, back to normal right now. In Jesus Christ's name, this person is losing a lot of weight. Or is putting on a lot of weight. This person cannot sleep well. This person cannot sleep well. Spirit of the devil, leave this body. Spirit of the devil, leave this life right now. I command you, insomnia, insomnia. You are under the bed of this person. You are inside of that bedroom. I rebuke you, insomnia, depression, anxiety, the pain in this body. In Jesus Christ's name, everybody say it loud and clear. In Jesus' name. All diseases disappear now. Disappear now. Raise now the Bible, the water. Receive the prophecy now. Receive the prophecy. The word of God is living and powerful. Receive the prophecy in the name of Jesus Christ. Drink now 3 sips of your water. 3 sips of your water. I believe in you.
I believe in you. You are the God of miracles. I believe in you. I believe in you. You are the God of miracles.
Be healed, be healthy, and be free. I want you now, amen, open your eyes. Do what you could not do. If you have this spine problem, go ahead, move your back. Take some exercise, some workout now. Yes, somebody to work out. Move your legs. Yes, move your legs. Yes, do what you could not do, your arm. Do not learn to live with the disease, with the enemy. Yes, move your body right now. Move yourself. Do some movement right now. Move yourself. Because the Lord Jesus Christ has healed you. The prophecy has taken place. Who was feeling pain and the pain disappeared? Over here or over there? I was feeling pain. I drank the water now and the pain disappeared in my body. Show me your hands. Let me see. Let us go past. Let us take some testimony. I was feeling pain. This pain disappeared. Go ahead, pastor. Talk to the people.
What you were feeling before, drink the water.
I was feeling pain in my shoulder and all the way down my back to my leg.
For how long?
Oh, this has been about 4 months now.
Do what you could not do. Lift up your hand. Yes, move, move. Up and down, up and down. She's free. She's healed.
The Lord Jesus Christ just healed her by drinking the water. Who else? Who else? Go over there, pastor.
Your name?
Jennifer.
Miss Jennifer, how you were feeling before coming here this morning?
I have a pain in my foot bottom in the left.
How long?
3 months now.
Did you take any medication, a pill? Did you try anything? What did you do? What did you take?
Take medication. Also, in the nighttime, you put the bottle of water in the fridge with ice, and then I just like exercise the foot, but not in the pain. It's horrible. But before I come to church, it was hurting. I know that I'm here. I feel much better.
Please move your leg. Do what you could not do. Yes, yes. It's strong, it's strong. Jesus healed her. She's free.
She's healed by the power of God. Healed by the power of God. Amen. Listen up. You are not feeling pain, but you have this health condition, problem. What you are going to do? You are going to see the doctor again. See the doctor again. Mrs. Silva went to the doctor. They drew blood, did the test 2 days. They called with the good result. You are going to hear a good result. Believe in prophecy. At the end of this month, it's going to be January 29th. I'm going to give it to you a bottle of oil. The oil that we blessed in Israel. The same oil that we blessed in Israel, we are going to distribute to you. On the 29th. Amen. These are the tools of faith. The same oil that we are using to bless your hands, to bless you financially, we are going to distribute it to you. And more miracles will happen in your life. You may go back to your place. You are healed. This is a prophecy. You are healed and you are blessed in the name of Jesus Christ. Are you trusting you? Oh, are you trusting you? Let us bless the kids. Bring the kids here, please.
Let the weak say I am strong.
Take the pictures of your family. The pictures of your family. Of the Lord, I will trust in you. Oh yes, I will trust.
I will trust in you.
Let the weak say.
Let the weak say.
I am strong.
Am strong in the strength of the Lord.
You are my hiding place. You always fill my heart. going to pray for the family, but I want to pray for the kids as well. I don't know if you heard about that, but a 6-year-old child shot his teacher. Did you hear that? 6 years old. He had the loaded gun, and he took the gun to school only because he had an altercation with his teacher. 6 years old. Six. Did I say 16? Did I say 60? 6 years old. A baby. What are the authorities going to do? Arrest? Put him in jail? The teacher was injured and hospitalized. 6 years old. So every Sunday, bring your children to the church. The first Sunday of the month, we bless, anoint them. We anoint and we bless the kids. They don't understand many things, but you bring them to the church. Amen? Hold the pictures now of your family. Open your eyes. Your family is not your enemy. Listen to me, please. Your family is not your enemy. Bishop, but my son is rebellious. He's not your enemy. My daughter, she's not your enemy. My son, my father, my husband. Hey, don't fight against the wrong person. You have to fight against the devil, not against the person. If you want to fight somebody, fight the devil. Don't fight your family. Hold these pictures now and close your eyes. Oh, Holy Spirit, my God and Father, I pray to you right now and I ask you, Lord, that you may bless these kids here before the altar. Because, my Lord, an 8-year-old child, 8 years old, 6 years, I mean, he shot his teacher, 6, a baby. How can a baby, 6 years old, know how to use a gun, how to shoot? And he did hit the target. Because Satan sees no age. Satan came to steal, to kill, to destroy. And he used even babies. My Lord, protect our kids. Anoint our kids with your anointing. Protect them from drugs, from prostitution, from the evil ones. Oh Lord, we bless our family. We want our family one by one to know you. One by one to come to you. So Holy Spirit, save our house. So Holy Spirit, save our family. Remove these addictions. Remove these fights, misunderstanding from the family. Remove it, oh Lord. And this person that doesn't have a family, give it to this person a family. Make them to be united. Make them to be together. Make this family to be saved. Make this family to be united as never before. Because I bless each one of them in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Have a seat, please. Praise God. Be seated. Amen. I want to show to you now this testimony. I want you to watch the story of this lady. Don't let anything to disturb you during this video. Because this testimony is a wake-up call. Pay attention to the details. Pay attention to what this lady is saying in her testimony. Listen to the story. Get the spirit. Because thereafter, we are going to pray for your relationship with the Lord. Can I show it to you? Can I? Please, be careful. Watch it carefully.
My name is Christiane, and I'm 41 years old, and I'm a securities administrator. When I was around 10 years old, I was very sad and felt a deep emptiness inside. I always attributed that sadness to the fact that we had no money, that we didn't have many things. And so I thought, okay, let me get involved in fashion so I can be happy. The women I saw seemed so beautiful, and they were always smiling and had everything money could buy. So I thought, that's what I'll invest my life in. So I took a modeling course. I learned how to walk down a catwalk, to pose for pictures. I joined in competitions, except that I also had an inferiority complex. I entered into a competition and I came in third place. But later we discovered that there had been fraud involved. So I thought to myself, I'm not going to stop being happy, and I don't want to become a prostitute, except instead of becoming an ordinary prostitute like the other girls, I became a call girl for businessmen. I started studying more. I studied English. I took swimming lessons. I worked out at the gym. I invested more of myself into what I was doing than ever before. And a little while later, I found out that I was pregnant. I was 16 years old when I found out that I was pregnant. I was just a teenager. My world fell apart. I was desperate. I needed my body to be happy, to fill that emptiness. And now I knew that my body was going to become deformed through my pregnancy. A few months went by and I had an ultrasound that was scheduled. They told me, your child is going to be born with serious permanent neurological problems, hydrocephaly, congenital deformities, and various other complications that, according to the doctor, were because I didn't have enough folic acid in the first 15 days of gestation, because I rarely ate, since gaining even 1 pound was too much for me. So I sank into depression. That deep sadness and emptiness just multiplied. I thought, it's all over for me. I'll never be happy. My life had finished because of that pregnancy and all the problems that child would have. I quit my studies. I had no motivation. I cried every single day. I had no strength to do anything. I only did the basics. I'd shower, cut my nails, and that was it. I couldn't do anything else. I wouldn't talk to any people anymore. Some of my family members would say to me, you look different. You look so strange. But it was because I couldn't overcome that sadness. It was like that sadness had taken control over me completely. I saw no more pleasure or happiness in anything in life. My mom could see me suffering. And she was walking down the streets and she made a prayer. My God, please help us. And as she walked, she passed by Universal Church and walked in. A little while later, she invited me to come as well. So I went with her. I was focused on solving my problems. I started to focus on the health of my baby. I wanted God to heal him, to answer me. I had a lot of anxiety. I thought that the sadness and the emptiness I felt could only go away if God answered that prayer. When I went to the church, I had already heard about heaven and hell, so I knew that taking my own life, that suicide, would mean losing my soul for all eternity. So I wasn't thinking of taking my life, but I really wanted to die. I remember the worst time when the thoughts got the worst was when I thought of my baby. Thoughts came to my mind. I remember them one day speaking into my mind as I was standing on the terrace of the house on the third floor. It was such a clear thought. Throw him off the terrace and you'll end his suffering. That was the worst moment for me. I didn't want to do that. I was a mother. But I was at the point where I couldn't take it anymore. He cried a lot. He went through lots of operations on his head, on his body, and I felt all alone. Even though my mother was close by, I felt so alone. So those thoughts, they really scared me. I thought, I'll end up actually doing this. One day I'll wake up and find out I've done it. A few years in the church passed, and I was healed of depression. I didn't want to die anymore. The thoughts of ending my son's life completely stopped. His health actually stabilized, and he stopped getting worse. But I still had that sadness. And I kept searching to fill that emptiness, which I thought was due to the situation that I was in. So I kept wandering in circles for 12 years. My focus was to have things, to have bread. I thought that having the bread that I wanted would satisfy the hunger of my soul. But it wasn't bread that I needed. It was the Holy Spirit. It seems odd, right? 12 years in the Universal Church that always had preached about the Holy Spirit, yet it was like my eyes were always looking for proof. I rarely read the Bible because I couldn't understand it. I was really unmotivated. I'd read a verse. I remember I'd read just one verse every month. For me, going to the church was all I needed. I'd just go to the church because there the pastor would preach the word and explain it to me so I could understand. Except that I didn't really understand it completely. Not in my spirit. I was deceived. I was truly deceived. I stopped and I analyzed myself and thought, there's something wrong with me. Why is this sadness still here? Why is this emptiness, this hunger for financial blessings, for example, why is it still here? Something doesn't add up. This made me try to reason things out. And that's when I said, God help me. Have mercy on me. I stopped looking down at my problems. I stopped looking at my own desires. And I asked, give me your spirit because I don't have you inside of me. I remember telling God, I really need to fix my financial problems. I really need to, but I want your spirit. I don't want anything else. I want you first in my life. Hear my voice because I'm not hearing yours. Give me your spirit. It was a campaign of Israel when I had given my all, physically speaking, together with my will, with my dreams, with everything else, to ask for the Holy Spirit. And along with that, I had gotten baptized various times, but I told God, my all for your all. If there's anything I lack, I give you everything. I was baptized again, and that baptism was truly meaningful for me. It was on a Wednesday. The bishop led us to seek the Holy Spirit, and I remember the bishop gave a very simple message. He said, have the certainty of peace. The Holy Spirit is certainty and peace. And that was the moment when a peace and a certainty. And I remember I didn't feel a lot of emotions. It was a certainty and a peace. It was so simple, yet so profound. I said, my God, it's you. I had sought this peace for so long. I had sought for this certainty for such a long time, long time. I'd always been a very calculating person. I had a lot of doubts, a lot of insecurities. I was always reacting against people and things. But after this, I began to notice a change inside of me. So thoughts would still come, but I'd be able to overcome them. The sadness just disappeared. The problems, though, didn't disappear. My son was still a special needs child. I still had financial problems. There were problems in my family, but none of that could make me sad anymore. Those problems weren't inside of me anymore. They were on the outside, but what was inside of me now was peace. It was certainty. I wasn't worried anymore whether I'd have ground beneath my feet. Christianity today has peace, joy, pleasure. There's no way to hold so much joy, so much peace inside of me. My desire is to give to people all of this peace that I've received. I help in the church group Depression Has a Cure. I do it with all of my reverence, with all of my love and all of my care. But that strength inside of me is something else. I was able to get through the death of my son. He passed away at the end of the year on the 25th of December. I was burying my son. I lost my mother. I've had many other problems, some even bigger than the ones I've had before, because these were irretrievable losses. But the Holy Spirit has always been there, all the time. All that certainty just nullifies the emotions. I've gone through all of these challenges, but on the inside, I'm strong. Some people, some of them, ask me, how? I tell them it's the Holy Spirit. That's what He does. He's a strength inside of us. He's life. He colors the world. He gives joy to our soul. God's daily bread is my bread. He accompanies me. He's my safety. He's my Father, my guide. He's a presence, a constant presence. He's there all the time. I don't feel alone, not even for a moment.
Clap to Jesus, to Jesus. Come on now. Amen. She didn't say, I'm married now. She didn't say, I have a lot of money. Because she, when she came, she was a prostitute for businessmen since the age of 16. But what changed in this lady? The change happened inside of her when she received the Holy Spirit. She was bearing her child, her mom passed away. She started having more problems than when she first came. But remember, she was many years inside of the church wasting her time. She was searching for the bread, for the healing of her son. And she wasted her time. How many times was she baptized in water? How many times? Various times. Many times. Listen. But when she received the Holy Spirit, when she gave herself all for all, Jesus changed her life. Let us meditate on the Bible. Do you have your Bible? Please, every Sunday, bring your Bible. Though we show on the screen the scriptures, but I want you, please, bring your Bible. We are reading the book of, these days we are reading the book of the Gospel of Luke. Please, assistant, when we finish the service, let us give the calendar to everybody. Every month I give you what to read. And I want you to read with me, if you want, the book of Luke. However, now we are going to read chapter 12. Go to chapter 12, the Gospel of Luke, chapter 12. Luke chapter 12. Purify my heart. Let me be as gold and precious silver.
In precious silver.
Purify my heart.
Purify my heart.
Let me be as gold.
Let me be as gold.
Say pure gold.
Pure gold.
Refine as fire.
Refine as fire,
my heart's desire is to be say holy.
Holy.
Set apart. Set apart for you, Lord. I want to be holy.
Holy.
Set apart.
Set apart for you.
My master.
My master.
Ready to do your will. Ready to do your will. Amen. There, Luke chapter 12, verse 16. Then he spoke a parable to them, saying, the ground of a certain rich man yielded plentifully. There was abundance. And he thought within himself, saying, what did he say? What shall I do, since I have no room to store my crops? Listen, that man planted, and the harvest was so great. This is very dangerous. Jesus taught us to pray and seek, give us today our daily bread. Because when a person gets rich, power, means, excuse me, hey, they do what? They turn their back on Jesus. The testimony of Christian shows that fame, money, riches is not everything. A young girl thought, I'm going to post pictures on the internet. I'm going to be famous. I'm going to be among the celebrities. From time to time, you hear on the news that the celebrities, people that you used to follow, they just kill themselves, shoot themselves. Because now when the baby was born with defect, she want to jump from the building. A lady was testifying yesterday on the TV show, and she said, I did not need God. I had houses, I had money, I had cars, I was good. My sister was in the church praying, inviting me to church, and I said, I don't need your God. Because her God was her money. How many people come to church in search of a bread? They want a job. We pray, they get a job, and they leave the church. Will this job last forever? Even if it lasts forever, one day you retire. You leave the job. Jesus said, these people seek me for the bread and the fish. For what is perishable, you have to seek the Lord for what endures for life, eternal life. Amen? And this man, when he saw that his harvest was great, that he had reaped plentifully, he said, and now, what am I going to do? I have enough. I don't know. I don't have room to store all my goods. Then verse 18 says, so he said, I will do this. I will pull down my barns, because they are small, and build greater, and there I will store all my crops and my goods. And I will say to my soul, to say to my soul means to say to my heart. I'll say to my soul, I'll say to my heart. So, you have many goods laid up for many years. You are guaranteed. You are secure. Take your ease. Eat, drink, and be merry. But God said to him, fool. How does God call this kind of people? Huh? Fool. This lady, I mean, sorry. She was like that. She had a heavy money. I have a good job. Nothing can replace Jesus in your life. Hey. Nothing can replace Jesus in your life. Can I tell you something? Come on now. Can I tell you something? Even if you say no, you need to hear that. Satan invests in what you like. Satan invests in what you like. If your priority is your love life, Satan invests in it. Just to distract you, not to bless. Satan does not bless anybody. Satan deceives. If your priority is your finances, Satan will bring to you a lot in your hand. You're going to have your hands full. Job schedule, money. This lady said to me yesterday on the TV show, she said, I had money to change my whole furniture every year or every other year. I have money to travel all over, to buy whatever I wanted. And my sister was in the Universal Church praying for me. Praying for me. And I said, I don't go to this church. I don't go to your God. Because her hands were full, like the hands of this man, a lot of crops, goods. His hands were full. And he said to his soul, hey, soul, take it easy, buddy. Eat, drink, go to Paris. Don't read the Bible. Don't go to church. You are so young. When Satan, wants to deceive somebody, he tells you what you like to hear. You are so young. You are so beautiful, so pretty. You have money to spare. Why going to church? Sunday. No, Sunday morning, stay home. Stay home. Watch the show, the TV. What do they show Sunday morning? Games? What, people? Football games? Huh? Come on, people. Somebody to tell me. I'm never home Sunday morning. Sunday morning, I'm here. But for you who come every other Sunday, you might have the answer. Just kidding. But listen, Satan tells you, listen, they are going to show your game and you go to church? No. Hey, your family is coming from afar. Let us have a barbecue. Let us have lunch together. Let us have a big breakfast. Don't go to church Sunday morning. This is what Satan does. Satan wants to keep you busy. Do you remember Pharaoh? When Pharaoh saw in Egypt that people were returning to the real God, Pharaoh said, he called his officials and he said, let us make these people busy. Let us have them work harder. They have to work more and more. You know why? Because if they are busy working, they'll have no time for the Lord. This is Satan's strategy. Did you hear that, people? But Bishop, I need to work. I need to support my family. Please do. Please do. But above all, put your soul first, not your physical needs. Your soul is the first, because job will stay behind. Money will stay behind. House will stay behind. When a person dies, he came naked and he goes naked. That man, he thought, let us read again what he said. See the way that he said here on verse 19, I will say to my soul, soul, you have many goods laid up for many years. Apes, how many years? No. I'm asking you, how many years does the human being live? 100, 90, 80s. People are dying nowadays young. Young. And Satan deceives by saying, you have many things for many years. You don't have many years. Jesus is coming. Jesus is returning. And death every day is knocking on the door. Hey, look here. Take care of your soul. Don't be a fool. Jesus said, fool. 20. This night your soul will be required of you. Then whose will those things be which you have provided? Tell me, all your goods, all your money, your houses, your cars, who is going to possess it? Whose will it be? Because you are going to leave everything behind. Take care of your soul, my friend. Everything is important, but salvation is a must. Everything is important. Family, husband, wife, children, money, job, and business, everything. We are not here saying for you to go naked, to go hungry, to go homeless, to go alone in loneliness. No, understand the point. Above all comes your salvation. Make Jesus to be your priority. The number one, as he says on 21, so is he who lays up treasures for himself and is not rich. Come on now, is not rich? We have to be rich toward God. And I want to pray with you today for you to receive this treasure, the Holy Spirit. You are only rich when you have the Spirit of God living inside of you. You can be famous, like the testimony, she wants to be famous, and you see what Satan did in her life. You are only happy, only complete, when you have the Holy Spirit, which means Jesus living inside of you. Please stand right now. Please stand. Who understood this message? Show me your hands. We have to be rich. And if you did not understand anything, the Holy Spirit will clarify these points to you. You who want to have the Holy Spirit, you who want to receive the Holy Spirit, come here before the altar. Come before the altar to seek the Lord. Come before the altar. If you don't have yet the Holy Spirit, I want the Holy Spirit. He is the treasure. Maybe like this testimony, you have been many years in the church, but without the Holy Spirit, you are poor. Even you who say, but I got a job. Congratulations. I got a promotion. Congratulations. I got married. Congratulations. Hey, I got a raise, increase. Congratulations. But listen, unless you receive the Holy Spirit, you don't have anything. Because everything that you got will be left behind. Amen? The testimony, she was only complete when she received the Spirit of God. And she lost many things in life, yes? But she did not break. To the point to say, now I had more problems than before I came in. But with the Holy Spirit, I am strong. People, God wants you to be strong. Strong. I know that many times I annoy people when I say, read the Bible, and I will not stop annoying you. I will continue. Read the Bible. Stay on the Word. Wake up in the morning before time to have time to read the Bible. For me, the best time to read the Bible is in the morning. My mind is fresh. Read the Bible. Hey, dedicate yourself to read the Bible, to stay with the Lord. People usually they come to church only on Sundays. But throughout of the week, they are far. Read the Bible. Though the church is open every day, you should come more often to church. But do not hear the word only on Sunday and from the pulpit. Read the Bible yourself. The testimony said I was baptized various times. Why didn't it work? Why none of that baptism worked? Because she came here inside of the water. She was dry, came out wet, but she never died to the world, to the old life. The baptism only works when you dive your whole life. Who swims? Who swims or who knows how to swim? When you dive, which part of your body is wet? Come on, people. When you dive, you said you know how to swim. So then you know what I'm talking about. When you dive, which part of your body is wet? The whole body. Nobody dive inside of the lake, the pool, and just half of the body is wet. Or just one leg, one foot. When you dive, your whole body goes. So when you are baptized in water, your whole life goes. Your whole old life goes inside of the water. And when you come out, you are still human, right? Still human. You are not a ghost. You are not a machine, a robot. You are still human. You are still subject to mistakes. But your vow to die to this world is there. And then you start living newness. Newness of life. Amen? Close your eyes, please. Everybody, close your eyes. Change my heart, oh God. Make it ever true. Change my heart, oh God. May I be like you. Change my heart, oh God. This is your prayer, not just a song. Make it ever true. Change my heart. Change my heart, oh God. May I be like you. May I be like you. Place your hand upon your heart. Pray, sing, and say, change my heart, oh God. Change my heart, oh God. Make it ever true. Change my heart, oh God. May I be like you. May I be like you. Now you say to him, you are the potter. You are the potter. I am the make me, mold me and make me. This is what I pray. This is what I pray. Somebody somebody to say, you are the potter, you are the potter. Make me, mold me, and make me. This is what I pray. This is what I pray. Oh Lord, we don't want to be in church only for the perishable food, for the blessings that comes and goes. You healed 10 men with leprosy. Only one came back to seek salvation, and you said your faith has saved you. The others had faith to be healed, but only one receives salvation. Seek for your salvation now. Because the crops, the goods will perish, will finish. You need now to seek your salvation. Go ahead, open your mouth and say, Lord, more than everything, more than my goods, more than my family, my money, tell him more than my position, my job, my business, my love life, my career, more than everything, I need to be saved. What I have is for many years on earth, but when the soul departed from the body, everything will be left behind. Everything will be left. Others will use, possess it. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, we just want to be with you. Jesus, we just want to be with you in your presence, Lord. Please, oh Spirit of God, please, Spirit of the Lord, save people here. Seek for your salvation. He said to his soul, soul, take it easy. You say to your soul, be saved. You don't say, take your easy. But you say to your soul, take your salvation. Yes, invest now. Oh, Holy Spirit. A Spirit of divine God. You brought these people here today to be saved. You brought these people this morning to be saved. So Lord, work here among us. I cannot save anybody. I can preach, but only you can save. So save souls. Create inside of this person a desire to be in your presence, a desire to be with you. Oh, I am asking you, Lord, come to save. Enter this body, Lord, so that this person will have communion with you, my Lord. In Jesus Christ's name, place your hands upon your heart. Close your eyes. You know, when you watch a movie or series and it is says based on a true story, what you are watching on the screen happened to someone, and you watch that story, I say to you now, watch your own story. Who have you been before the Lord? Please be silent now. Watch now your true story. where you stand before the Lord. How is your relationship with the Lord? He said to his soul, take your ease, eat, drink, be merry. Now Satan says, go to Paris, do drugs, make easy money, illegal money, illegal business. Oh, my friends, the Lord is calling you today. Jesus is calling you. He's calling you to be saved, to be rich toward God. Not just to have goods to store, a lot of money in the bank, savings. Not just to have goods, many goods for many years, because you don't know how many years you have on earth. The story is now moving in your head. It's like you see yourself on the big screen. What you have done, the way you have been, your behavior. The Lord is calling you. Oh, Holy Spirit, prepare your church for the Lord's Supper. Prepare your church, because when this person eats and drinks from you, that this person may have you inside of them. I'm not praying for this person to be religious, but to have you inside of them. And this is the only moment in the church where we touch you, when we touch the bread, when we touch the juice, the blood, and when we participate, we partake, you enter us. But I don't want to eat and drink anyhow. But I want to eat and drink in the right way, the right manner. So change lives here, my Lord. Let these people be rich toward you. Rich toward Jesus. Hallelujah. Create in me a new heart, oh God, and renew a right spirit within me. Amen. Praise God. We are going to have now the Lord's Supper. The same God who blessed the life of Christiane, He's going to bless yours as well. You who are at home, you are not in church, you can get the piece of bread, you can get the cup of grape juice. If you don't have a grape juice, you can take water. And this water will be transformed into the blood of Jesus as well. But she had to make this important decision to turn her life to God. And she has now this communion with God. When you have communion with God, things like that, as it happened to her, can happen to you as well. But if you have the Spirit of God, as she said, now she has more problems than before, but she is stronger. Hold now the piece of bread. Close your eyes. Cast me not away from thy presence, O Lord. Take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and renew a right spirit within me. My Lord Jesus, we present this piece of bread to you, And we ask you, Father, that you may bless, that you may consecrate with your power. We are going to eat and receive strength from you, to be strengthened by your Holy Spirit. Our riches, our glory is to be rich toward God. We don't want to be like that man who had goods, crops for many years, but he did not live many years. Bless, Lord, consecrate in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Eat now the body of Christ.
Cast me not away from thy presence, O Lord. Take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and renew a right spirit within me.
Raise the grape juice or even a cup of water. Jesus transformed water into wine. And this water you have becomes the blood of Jesus to purify you, to clean you. We consecrate this grape juice in the name of Jesus Christ. Purify my sins, their sins. Purify us. There are people watching now, the Living Faith Network, Universe, people that are watching on many platforms, the virtual members on the conference. I want everybody, my Lord, to drink from you and receive your strength. Drink now the blood of Jesus.
Cast me not away from thy presence, O Lord. Take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of my salvation, and renew a right spirit within me. Pray to him, create in me a clean heart, oh God, and renew a right spirit within me. Create in me a clean heart, oh God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, oh God. Me, restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and renew a right spirit within me. Lift your hands and beg him now. Cast me not away from thy presence, oh Lord. Take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of my salvation,
sing strong as you pray. Cast me from thy presence, O Lord. Oh Lord, take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Take not from me. Restore unto me. Come on now. Restore the joy of thy salvation. And renew the right spirit within me. Now receive the Holy Spirit. If you have given, receive now. Give, it shall be given to you. Now you receive. Yes, now you receive. As you have given, now you receive. Yes, receive now, God. Receive it today, this morning, the Holy Spirit. Don't doubt. It's not by merit. It's not by merit. Regardless of who you are, receive the Holy Spirit. If your surrender was sincere, receive the Holy Spirit now. Yes, the servant of God, lay hands upon them to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Oh Lord, I perceive that you are here. Oh Lord, I know that you are here. And I know that you are moving among us, inside of this person. Receive the Spirit of God. Receive the Holy Spirit.
Unto me, the joy of thy salvation. And renew a right spirit within me.
Seek the Lord. Go ahead. Keep on going. Don't stop praying. Keep seeking.
On thy presence, O Lord. Take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, sing hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. The Spirit of God, the presence of God, He visits you, He embraces your life. The Holy Spirit, this morning, He fills your life. Don't ask for anything, just to worship Him. Yes, raise your hands, your face to the Lord. Raise your hands, your face. Lift up your face to the Lord. And just to worship, say, Jesus, I love you. Yes, let us go together. Jesus, I love you. Jesus, I adore you. Thank you, Lord, for your calling. You chose me among 8 billion. million people on earth, you chose me, and I thank you, Holy Spirit. And I adore you, Jesus. You are my love. You are my first love. I love you with all my strength, with all my heart. You are the number one. Yes, Jesus, more than money, more than fame, job, schedule, business, parents, children, spouse, friends, you are the number one. And I love you, Jesus. Oh, yes, you are my treasure. Oh, Lord, you are my treasure. And I want to be rich toward you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Rich toward you. Receive the Spirit of God. He embraces you. Even you who are for the first time, the babies, yes, everybody be filled with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Oh, glories and glories be given to you. Hallelujah. You are going to speak now to your soul. Speak to your soul. Say, soul, soul, you need to be saved. Speak to your soul, say, soul, you need to be in heaven. Hallelujah. Be saved now. Receive the assurance of your salvation. And this assurance brings you peace. No more condemnation, but peace. Peace inside of your soul. The Lord is your peace. Hallelujah. We give you thanks. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We praise your name. Hallelujah. We clap applauses only to Jesus. Applauses only to Jesus. We clap only to him. We clap our hands only to the Lord.
And I exalt your holy name. I exalt your holy name.
Say I exalt your holy name. Listen, I prayed to God this morning that nobody would leave the church the way they came. Maybe you almost missed church today. Something happened, you came last minute. Something happened, you almost missed, but God called you today. And I prayed this morning that nobody would leave the same way. You are not living the same way. They are going to see something different, and your week is blessed. So every Sunday, listen, every Sunday you need to be here. If you are not baptized in water, or you are baptized, but you feel like the lady said, that baptism did not work, I already thought about the baptism, you need to dive in order to be born again, born of the water. Amen? So if you need the baptism today, don't waste more time. Don't waste. This is January, the beginning of a new year. Let us do whatever we have to do to please the Lord. Right away. So when I finish the service, speak to one of the pastors and pass through the water. But Bishop, I'm not ready. I tell you now, you are ready. If your desire is to save your soul, this is what you need. So die for the world, for the past. Be baptized. You are still human. But your life begins anew, afresh. Be baptized. Every Wednesday, we have the night of the soul. Take care of your soul. He said to his soul, take your easy. You say to your soul, I needed to save you. So Wednesday, the night of sanctification. This Wednesday, I will be speaking about sanctification. That is holiness. Bring your Bible if you are interested in saving your soul. The night of sanctification. Amen? Come this Wednesday, 7 p.m. You may go back to your place right now. Everybody, go back to your place. My God is awesome. He can move the valley right me from. My God is awesome. He can move mountains.
In the valley,
ride me from the rain. My God is awesome. Heals me
when I am weak and
forever He reigns.
Awesome, awesome.
Come on now.
Awesome, He's awesome.
Awesome. He's mighty, awesome, He's awesome. Provider, 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 provider. Awesome, He's awesome. He's awesome, He's awesome, He's awesome, He's awesome. Awesome. Amen. Please be seated right now. Be seated. We are going to honor the Lord with the tithes and the offering. Those who brought their tithes today, listen, when you come on the altar, myself, the pastors, all of us, we are going to lay hands upon you. Last month, December, Bishop Macedo laid his hand upon us. We laid hands upon the pastors. And today we are going to lay both our hands upon you. To bless your life. This oil we poured upon the hands of the bishop. Because God has been blessing the work of His hand, our hands, in this ministry for almost 46 years. But the hands of the bishop, he was born with this hand body defect. And as a kid, teenager, he suffered bullying. He had to keep his hand in his pocket, because he was embarrassed, and the people mocking his hand. But you see, the scripture says that God chose things that are nothing to put to shame those who think they are. So whether you are black, white, pink, blue, tall, short, big, skinny, God has chosen you. And as we are going to place our hands upon the oil, we are going to lay hands upon you, and I invite you to do it on the altar of the church. On the altar. The Lord said, I will honor those who honor me. Look here, please. You had other choices this Sunday morning. As we spoke previously, you could be home watching TV, cooking, doing something else. But you woke up early and you came to church. To honor who? And now God has to honor you. This is tithe. Tithe is not money. Change your mind. Change your mentality. Maybe, hey, nobody ever explained to you that tithe is linked to our salvation. Yes, it is. Tithe is linked to our salvation. I don't need a tithe envelope to remind me that I have to tithe. I don't need to hear the pastor say, bring the tithe, bring the tithe, bring the tithe for me to bring my tithe. Why not? Because my relationship with God does not allow me to forget the tithe. Oh, but I'm not coming to church today. Yes, but what is God's? I already separate, it's already holy, it's already His. Are you following me? Are you with me or not? Have this relationship with God. A person received a small amount, they tithe. But when they receive a big amount, they don't tithe. Because now they say, it's a lot of money to church. Because in their mind, they are giving money to the church. No, the scripture says, I will honor those who honor me. And those who despised me will be lightly esteemed. Lightly esteemed. When you tithe, you burn Satan. When you tithe, you say to Satan, Jesus Christ is the Lord, is the number one in my life. God doesn't see your 10% bigger than mine. Mine greater than yours. No. The amount might be different, but the meaning must be the same. Firstborn, first fruit. Amen. Who has children? Children. Who has more than one? More than one? More than five? If I may ask, Miss, how many? And you, more than seven? Anybody more than seven? How many, man? How many? Eight? And you? Let me stop here. Okay, thank you. But these mothers, they have seven, eight, nine, 10, 12. But they never forget. Come on. You who have more than one, do you forget the first one? And then you say, but Bishop, I love all of them. I know that. I know that. But the first one, it was the first pregnancy. It was the first pain. The first time you delivered, everything was new for you. Even if you had others, but the first one, you never forget. So tithe is the same. Tithe is the same. Tithe is like the firstborn, the first fruit. You don't forget it. Amen? So when you come on the altar, we are going to lay both our hands upon you. Just as God has been blessing this ministry, He's going to bless you in this year 2023. And you never stop tithing. And your tithe will increase more and more and more. And you'll be faithful in little, also in much. Hold the tithe in your hands. Hold the tithe in your hands. I will lay hands upon you to bless your life. But I want to pray for everybody, even you who decide today to start the new year. From January, to be faithful to God. Whatever comes to your hand, God's first. It is written there on the money, in God we trust. But the people trust more in that money than God. That's why they forget God. Stand, please, everybody. I will pray for those who brought and those who didn't. But those who want to be faithful to God, close your eyes. My Lord Jesus, you do not forget the faithful tithers. You do not forget the faithful givers. So I pray to you, my Father, bless the faithful ones. My Lord, open the floodgates of heaven. do what is written. I will honor those who honor me. And just as this person honors you, honor this person as well. Remember then when they work, when they pay, when they buy. Remember, my Lord, this person. And let this person be a blessing in the name of Jesus Christ. And the works, raise your hands now. The works of their hand shall prosper. The works of their hand shall be prosperous. Bless them, my Father. When they are by, when they are working, when they are doing business, make their fridge to be full of food. Their pantry, wallet, savings account, banking account. Oh Lord, let the blessings be upon them. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. You are going to come here on the altar. Here on this treasure box, you are going to place the tithe, place your vow, and then you go back to your place. And those who are at home, you can call this number, return the tithe. You can call this number, sow the seeds, and be blessed. Bring your tithe. Come this way right now. And come to honor the Lord. I will give my Jesus.
I will give my Jesus, my life and my soul. I will give, I will give, I will give, I will give my Jesus, my life and my soul. I will give. What can I give to you, oh my Lord? My soul is anxious to
the tithe envelope, you need the tithe envelope, you are going to raise your hand, the assistant will bring it to you. If you need to use the machine to return the tithe today, the machines are available. How you give my Jesus, my life and my soul. I will give all to you.
Give, Lord Jesus, my life.
The others, have a seat, please.
My soul, I will.
If you need the tithe envelope, raise your hand to receive. All to you. I will give my Jesus, my life and my soul. I will give my life and my soul.
I will give.
Please close your eyes now. Oh Jesus, I'm not demanding more than what is promised. What I am demanding from you is what is promised. When it says, I will honor those who honor me. Look at these people that came here to honor you. Not the church, not the bishop, the pastor. But they are here to honor you. Receive, Lord, their honor. I know Satan hates when we honor you, but we decided to honor you. Receive, my Lord, all the honor, and honor your people as well. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Listen, right now you are going to separate your offering, that is your seed, to honor the Lord. If you say, I did not bring the tithes today, don't worry about. Next week, we are going to do the hands once again. Actually, next week, we are going to anoint your hands with the same oil. But right now, you are going to separate your offering, and you are going to bring this offering. We have another treasure box here, and you are going to put inside of this treasure box. Amen? Prepare your offering right now. Let us offer the Lord our best. Give it to the Lord, and the Lord shall give it to you. Come here and give it to him. Put inside of this treasure box. Can I have that one, please? The treasure box. Somebody to help me here. An assistant, hold the offering bag over there. Go ahead. Bring your offering and give it to the Lord. Give it to him, and much more the Lord will give it to you. How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. And all you see, how. Give me the treasure box here, please. Can you put it here?
Is my God.
Put your offering here inside.
Great is my God.
Sing with me, how great is our God. And all you see, how great is our God. This is my soul, my Savior God, to thee. I don't hear your hands. Is a God, and all you see, how. Come on now, come on. How great is a God, the splendor of a king, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice. Every joy, he wrapped himself in light, and darkness died to hide. Tremble at your voice, tremble at his voice. How great. How great is our God, and all you see, how great.
Amen.
Did you realize how wonderful, how great it is to be Sunday morning in the house of God? How many people were in church one day, Sunday morning? Now, what are they doing? They were pastors, bishops, assistants, members of the church. They backslide. They fell back. What are they now, right now? They have no strength even to pray. God had mercy on me and on you and brought us here today. Yes? So before we go, remember, it's so great to be Sunday morning, beginning the week, in the presence of the Lord. Though the church is open every day, right? Right? Tomorrow, 7 in the morning, 10 in the morning, 4 p.m., 7 p.m., the Strong Nation. Work on your finances. But Sunday morning is different from any other day. It's the tithe. How do you feel now? We have finished the service. You are going home. How do you feel now? Every Sunday, let us be here. Even if it is snowing, cold, you still come into church. As we do go to work when it's cold, snowing, school. So no excuses accepted. We have to be here. Amen? Close your eyes. My Lord Jesus, here before the altar. I could have dismissed the people from there where they were seated. But I called them near the fire. As they are stepping out of this place, go, my Father, with them. Protect their lives from all evil. And this week is blessed because this person is strengthened by the power of the Holy Spirit. Receive the fire of the altar. Receive it right now. Outside is cold, freezing, but you receive the fire of God inside of you. The weather is cold, but the Spirit is on fire. Flames of fire. May my God keep, guard, and bless you. May the light of God shine upon your faith. May the Lord Jesus lift you and protect you. May the Lord Jesus lift the countenance of your faith. Be gracious and merciful and give you peace. May the God of the Bible bless all of you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Clap to our Lord Jesus Christ.
Hello, friends. Did you enjoy the service today? The message? What stood out for you in this message? The message, the testimony, the prayers. Well, you can participate in a service like this in one of our churches. We have the Universal Church all over USA. In majority of these states, we have the Universal Church. Go to one of the churches and join us in person. I know you enjoyed it live here on the network. However, I invite you to join us in one of our locations, and the pastors will be praying for you. If you are in a city, in a state where there is no Universal Church, you can watch us again next week here on the same channel. However, every Sunday, 10 o'clock in the morning, we have this special service. We named it as Gathering of Faith and Miracles. May the God of the Bible bless all of you. Thank you for watching us, and also thank you for your support. When you make your donation, your seed offering, your gift of any amount, we send it to you as a gift. One of these books that also has messages like the one that you heard today in our service. God bless you. See you next time.
Hi there! Did you know that you can watch the Living Faith Network through a variety of platforms?
For DirecTV users, we can be found on channel 379. And we are also available on Verizon channel 794. If your cable provider is Comcast or Xfinity, you can find your local listing and look for the Living Faith channel in your area. For those who live in California, find us on channel 63. And if you live in South Florida, you can watch us on channel 18, WDLF. And for those living in Georgia, find us on channel 21.2. You can also watch us 24 hours a day on Roku TV and Apple TV. If you'd like to watch us on your mobile device, both our Living Faith Network and our website is available for streaming 24 hours a day, and it's completely free of charge. iPhone users can download the Living Faith Network app on the Apple Store, while the Android users can download our Living Faith Network app on the Google Play completely free. We are still growing across the US, and soon we will be spreading throughout the Caribbean islands. In Trinidad, you can find us either on Flow or Amplia providers on channel 107. And in Tobago, we are available on your local cable 22. And if television isn't your thing, do not worry. Just download the Tigo app and search for Gaili. Then scroll down and you're gonna see the Living Faith Network. For more information, you can call us at 888-332-4141 or 888-691-2291. And no matter where you are, we will always be there for you.
If you have a question, send us a text at 1-888-312-4141. Our team will reach out to you.